Welcome to Making It Australia, the crafter show, where we're going to be recapping every episode of this season of Making It Australia. My name is Chilly Philly. I'm a crochet artist, and every week I'm going to be joined by a new, fun, crafty guest. And this week I'm joined by craft-based designer Kitiya Palaskas. How are you going? Woo!
Hi, Phil. Thanks for having me. So excited to be here.
And so what are you thinking about the show so far?
Well, I'm loving it. It's actually just so great to see makers from around Australia championed in this way and showcased. And yeah, I'm just really looking forward and excited about just getting to know them all and what they can bring to the crafting world.
So I introduced you as a craft-based designer. How would you describe your sort of craft world to somebody?
So basically, I'm a multidisciplinary crafter. I specialize in creating props, DIY content, illustrations, installations, and also facilitating creative workshops for commercial clients all over the world.
Yeah. Do you think you could apply that to a lot of these challenges then, like sort of this big scale, little scale, all those sorts of things?
I was actually thinking about that. There were so many moments watching the episode where I was like, oh my God, I'm loving that there's mini versions of something, or I'm loving that there's giant versions of stuff. So I was definitely into it from that perspective.
Which is really funny because the theme for this week is home sweet home. So, you know, this week they've worked with something really small and then they've also worked with something really big. And for the faster craft, the challenge was to take their hometown and turn it into some sort of diorama or terrarium. Where are you from, and like what sort of terrarium would you be at make?
Well, I don't really have a hometown. I'm from all around the world. I've lived in lots of different countries. My mum's Thai, my dad's Greek. I was born in New Zealand. So it would be kind of hard to pinpoint like one location, but I reckon I would probably recreate a terrarium sized version of my studio because I spend literally every single day in it and I love it. And I'd probably do something like recreate all my favorite tools and stuff, but make them like super small.
Who was your favorite terrarium?
Okay, so I loved George's creation. I just thought it was so well executed. Obviously, I expected it to be so because she's a prop maker. So I just loved the attention to detail, especially those mini versions of like the printed menu. I thought yes, that was clever. Yes. And I do have to shout out to the vomit. That was a nice touch. Not totally unexpected, but like really loved that humor.
It's great that you thought George was the best because George won the faster craft, which I agreed with as well. It was definitely
totally well deserved. And I loved the excitement in her face when it was announced that she was a winner. I think that was, yeah, very well done, George. Well done.
Yeah. Woo. I know it was long overdue. Woo. I think she needed a patch a long time ago. And for this week's Mastercraft is to create your own happy place. What would you create? What is your happy place?
This is going to sound so sad because it's the same thing as my terrarium. I think I would create my studio, but I think I would play with scale in the opposite direction and I would create my studio, but like a giant version. So like giant versions of my favorite scissors, giant versions of my favorite pencil. And you would walk in and it would just be like, you're a tiny little person inside like this strange giant world of stationery and craft supplies. Is that weird?
No, well, there's some examples behind you.
Actually, yes, there is. So yeah. There you go. We definitely did see some of the contestants in this episode use the idea of a room or like the idea of hanging out with their loved ones in a room for their Mastercraft project.
Yeah, one of the things with this challenge, I think with a lot of the people, is that they either went with a conceptualized version of a room or a room, like a room that exists. But I think the thing is that I think the rooms that sort of were more conceptual definitely sort of resonated more with at least me. I don't know about you, but I liked the idea of exploring sort of an idea with craft as opposed to using your craft skills to create a functional room.
Yeah, I'd have to agree. I think the ones that did play with a kind of fantasy dream or like some kind of concept like that really appealed to me. Like, so my favorite was Rizaldi. Mm-hmm. Loved
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
good. At first, when I first saw like the bucket tree and the foam without it being finished, I was like, I found it really hard to see what his completed vision was. But when we saw the finished product, oh my gosh, I was really blown away. Like it was really well done.
And who else were your favorites then?
I definitely also love Sidewise. I thought that she kind of blended those two ideas we were just talking about, kind of like a literal room and also the concept of one with her fantasy bath spa experience. I really enjoyed that. I thought it looked really relaxing, and I love that she used like a bath as a prop too. That was cool. Yeah.
But luckily for you, both the things you've liked this episode have won. So Saiwai wins the challenge as well, which I agree with as well. I really loved the painting. I really loved the effect of everything.
Oh, yeah. Can we just talk about how she managed to fit in an entire painterly mural into her challenge? Like, that was incredible. Yeah.
And so poor Stephanie has to go home. It was sad, but it wasn't unexpected, I would say.
She had a lot of really creative ideas, and you could tell that she was really tapping into like things from the heart, like in the sort of subject of the things that she chose to make. I would have loved to have seen, I guess like a little bit more in her execution or a little bit more polished to her work. But I thought she had some really heartfelt ideas.
Well, thank you, Kit, for coming. It's been so much fun. It was fun watching the show with you.
I loved it.
If you want people to follow you, where can they find your stuff?
Well, you can say hi over on Instagram. I'm at Kitiya Palaskas, or you can explore all the DIYs that I've made over at my website, kitiyapalaskas.com.
Kit, awesome. Well, thank you. And thank you, everybody, for watching today's Crafter Show. Join me again tomorrow for another recap of Making It Australia. Until then, keep crafting. Bye.
Bye.